So good afternoon. So very good afternoon, dear students. So we'll commence with this discussion of NEET Grand Test paper 5. So the previous papers, I've already uploaded it in the YouTube channel also. You can have access to that. So now the first question that you had for this was, which one of the following vertebrate has cartilaginous cranium? So it has cartilaginous cranium and vertebral column. So is it pterophyllum or is it cetacula or is it petromyzon or pteropus? So which among them has cartilaginous cranium and vertebral column? Okay, so anyone can guess what the answer is. Okay, so the point that you have to remember is it's in petromyzon. So you find this cartilaginous lamprey. So they have this cartilaginous cranium. It is not made up of bony cranium and they have vertebral column. So petromyzon is the answer for that. So the third one is the answer for this animal which has cartilaginous cranium and vertebral column. So second question that we have for our discussion is the translocation of organic solutes through phloem is bidirectional because source and sink are irreversible in any season. Translocation is of ATP regulated process. Source and sink relationship is variable depending upon season or need of plant. Always root acts as a source and leaf act as a sink. So which would be the appropriate answer for that? So the source and sink relationship is variable depending upon season. So in the onset of early spring, I told you the root would be the source region and the young buds would be the sink region. So source and sink relationship is variable depending upon season or need of a plant. So that is the reason this third one is the correct option. So second one, the correct option is third one. So nitrates and phosphates are plant nutrients, but they act as prime contaminants in. So nitrates and phosphates, they are the plant nutrients, but they act as prime contaminants in. Is it in biomagnification, water logging and soil salinity, cultural eutrophication, desertification? So especially in this cultural eutrophication, you can notice this part of it wherein, so the phosphates and nitrates are the pollutants, primary pollutants in case of the cultural eutrophication. So the enrichment of water bodies with nutrients, we call it as eutrophication. So the water from the agricultural fields which enters into the lake, so they are going to be the lead to cultural eutrophication. So just remember about that. The problem of blindness in poor countries can be overcome by using, I think this is very easy option. So vitamin A deficiency I told you about. Excuse me. So it is BT cotton, transgenetic tomato, BT brinjal, golden rice. Which is the answer for this, dear students? I think almost all of you might have answered this. So the vitamin A deficiency, yes, it is. The D is the answer for that fourth one, golden rice. Okay, so it is having this vitamin A genes. So they are golden yellow in color because of the presence of carotenoids. So the problem of blindness in poor countries can be overcome by using this golden yellow rice or golden rice. So fifth question, what about the fate of pressure in the left ventricle to open semilunar valve during cardiac cycle? So the what is the fate of pressure in the left ventricle to open semilunar valve during the cardiac cycle? So there are options like the pressure should be equal to the pressure in atrium, greater than the pressure in aorta, semilunar valves it is, so it is not concerned with bicuspid, tricuspid valves. So just remember about it. And it is left ventricle. Left ventricle pumps the blood into the aorta so that they can distribute the blood throughout the body. So it has to be aorta. That point we are very clear about. So the fifth question, so the pressure should be greater than the pressure in aorta. So it should have a greater than the pressure in aorta. Only then the semilunar valves can open up. So the pressure in the left ventricle to open semilunar valve during cardiac cycle, it should be greater than the pressure in aorta. Only then the semilunar valves can open and the blood can gush into or rush into this aorta, which supplies this pure blood to all parts of the body. So the sixth question, increased vacuolation, cell enlargement, and new cell wall deposition are the characteristics of cell in. So there is an increased vacuolation, cell enlargement, and new cell wall deposition are the characteristic of cell in. Which phase do you come across this? Is it in the divisional phase or is it in the maturation phase, differentiation phase? So there is cell enlargement. So it should be the elongation phase. The right answer is in elongation phase, you come across increased vacuolation, cell enlargement, and new cell wall deposition are characteristic of this cell elongation phase. So fourth one is the right answer for this. Seventh one, in angiosperms, functional megaspore develops into male gametophyte, embryo, endosperm, embryo sac. So female gametophyte is also called as embryo sac, isn't it? So embryo sac is found within the ovule. Towards the micropylar region, they have the egg apparatus. Towards the chalazal region, they have the antipodal cells. So the in angiosperms, functional megaspore develops into the embryo sac. Seventh one is, fourth one is the right answer. Follow the features of centrally located nuclei, following features, okay? So single layer of cuboidal cells, microvilli at free surfaces of cells. Where do you find the epithelium with the above features? So it is a centrally located nuclei, single layer of, that is simple cuboidal epithelial cells with microvilli or brush border. So where do you find this attributes of this epithelium? So you have to give that example of this. So is it in the proximal convoluted tubule of nephron, lining of stomach and intestine? See, if villi is there, it increases the surface area of absorption. So the answer would be the proximal convoluted tubule of nephron. You can find this cuboidal cells with microvilli. So you can notice it there, PCT of nephron. So eighth one, first choice is the right answer. Ninth one, the characteristics developed by a warm-blooded animal of colder region for heat gain, A, and preventing heat loss, B. So what is the characteristics developed by a warm-blooded animal of colder region for heat gain? What is the A part of it? Preventing heat loss, B part of it. Okay, so the right answer for this is, again, so more volume is found in the colder region for heat gain, so there is more volume. So the warm-blooded animals, they'll be having more volume. And to prevent heat loss, so they'll be having the less surface area. So for heat gain, they'll have more volume. To prevent heat loss, there would be less surface area. So for heat gain, they'll have a larger volume. For preventing heat loss, they'll have lesser surface area. So these are the things that you can remember about in case of warm-blooded animals, which are included. For gaining heat, they'll have more volume. For preventing loss of heat, they'll have less surface area. Okay, so 10th option, in Mendel's experiments, the alleles were codominant, incomplete dominant, dominant recessive, all the above. So the 10th one, it is dominant recessive. In Mendel's experiments, the alleles were, law of dominance is there, isn't it? So dominant and recessive. So one of them is dominant, another is recessive. The alleles are contrasting genes. So for tallness, it is capital T, small t. Capital T is dominant, small t is recessive, okay? which one of the following set contains edible crustaceans? Okay, so edible crustaceans, eatable crustacean, is it king crabs and crayfishes, snails and oysters, crabs and prawns? So crabs and prawns are the edible crustaceans. So 11th one, third is the answer. So 11th one, third is the answer. So doubts, I'll be clarifying it at the end of the session, Kusumanjali. So let me complete it. Make a note of questions which you have doubts at. So I'll be completing it, or I'll be discussing it after the completion of paper. Okay. So let us next go for the match the following. So here column one and column two are there. So olfactory bulb, dialysis, optic chiasma, organ of Corti. Okay, so we have to identify so the right choices for that. So olfactory bulb, so it is an extension of limbic system. So olfactory bulb is an extension of limbic systems. Dialysis, so dialysis is utilized whenever there is renal failure, isn't it? So dialysis is an indication of renal failure. So olfactory bulb is second option, dialysis is first one. Optic chiasma, so C is going to be the nerve cross. Optic chiasma is the nerve cross. So organ of Corti is basilar membrane. Organ of Corti is basilar membrane. So the first one, A is 2, B is 1, C is 4, D is 3. This is the correct option that you have to remember. So olfactory bulb is an extension of limbic system. Dialysis is done when there is a renal failure or kidney failure. Optic chiasma is a nerve cross. The crossing of that nerves is called as nerve cross. Organ of Corti is found in the basilar membrane. So the first choice is the correct one for this 12th question. Let us proceed to the 13th one. Lac operon is turned on when lactose molecule binds to, is it promoter site, repressor molecules, or is it mRNA or I gene? So lac operon is turned on when lactose molecules bind to the repressor molecule. So 13th one is second one. So when lactose binds to repressor molecule, lac operon operates and there is the synthesis of this enzymes. Okay, beta galactosidase, beta galactoside transaminase, transacetylase. So we have three enzymes synthesized when lac operon is switched on. So that is going to happen because lactose molecule binds to repressor molecule. That is the 13th one. 14th question, in one polynucleotide chain of DNA molecule, the ratio of A plus T or G plus C is 0.3. What is the ratio of A plus G by T plus C in the entire DNA molecule? Okay, so you have to find what is the ratio of A plus G or T plus C in the entire DNA molecule. So 0.3, A plus T is 0.3. If you want to find out T value, so what will be the T value of it? See, T will be 0.3 minus A. So that way you can take it up as 0.3 minus A. So A plus G, you can write it as 0.3 minus A. So A plus and minus A, they get it as 0.3 divided by T plus C. Again, A plus G, we have found A plus T. So you can replace one of the values of the T. So T, and then you get the entire. So replacing those values, so you have to work that out. I'll be sending it as in a small list later in the group. So you'll be knowing that the answer is going to be 0.3 divided by 0.3. So 0.3 ones are, 0.3 ones are. So second one is the answer. So 14th, one is the answer. So A plus G by T plus C in the entire DNA molecule, it would be, the answer would be one. Okay. So which of the following represents the correct combination without any exception? So mouth terminal, moist skin without scales, two pairs of limbs, eyes with eyelids. So is it amphibia? So the 15th question. So first choice is this contribution part of it. So here it is going to be wrong. Okay, it's not amphibia. So terminal mouth, moist skin without scales. So it is not amphibian. So then bony endoskeleton, gills with operculum, skin with cycloid scales, internal fertilization. So is it osteichthyes? So second one is also wrong because bony fishes exhibit external fertilization. So third one, external ear openings absent, three-chambered heart, internal fertilization. Okay, so external ear openings absent, three-chambered heart with partially divided ventricle, internal fertilization, reptilia, and body is covered with cornified skin. So reptilia, 1 or 2 points are wrong here, but otherwise it's fine. Then body covered with feathers, bony endoskeleton, oviparous, direct development, AVES. So this is the correct option. 15th one, fourth is the correct option. So all the points are relevant and correct. So fourth is the absolutely perfect answer. Correct combination with all the attributes. 16th one, slime molds. Are they parasites or do not produce spores, do not produce fruiting bodies, saprophytic? See, slime molds in protists, we have studied about them, isn't it? So kingdom protista. Saprophytic they are. So they are dependent upon dead and decaying organic elements of organisms. So slime molds are saprophytic. Fourth is the right answer. So 16th is, fourth is the right answer. 17th one, residual volume is not taken into consideration in measuring of these two capacities of the lungs. So which are those two aspects of it? So in vital capacity is ERV plus IRV plus, so the tidal volume, okay? So they are not going to take into consideration residual volume. So vital capacity, they are not going to take. Expiratory capacity, they are also not going to take the residual volume into consideration. So first choice is the correct one. Vital capacity and expiratory capacity does not take residual volume in measuring the capacity of the lungs. So they don't take the residual volume. So those answers are vital capacity and expiratory capacity. So the first one is the right answer. Acrosome reaction facilitates, what does it facilitate? Spermatogenesis, or does it facilitate sperm motility, sperm entry into ovum, spermiation? So acrosome, they are going to dissolve the membrane of the ovum, isn't it? So sperm entry into ovum. So the acrosome reaction facilitates the entry of sperm into ovum. So 18th one, third is the correct answer. 19th, which infectious particles lack genetic material? Infectious proteins or prions? So second one is the right answer. 19th, second one is the answer. 20th, which floral diagram represents the floral characters of Liliaceae? See, Liliaceae is a monocot family. It has two whorls of perianth. Okay, so in multiples of three, fourth diagram is the correct one. So this is the floral character of Liliaceae. The fourth diagram exhibits the floral diagram of Liliaceae. 21st, a cross between a plant heterozygous for both the gene pairs and a plant recessive for both the gene pairs gives the phenotypic ratio of, for a dihybrid, it's a test cross. Test cross is always any parent multiplied with the recessive parent, we call it as test cross. So if the values are all, if it's a heterozygous crossed with, the recessive parent, the values are all going to be 1:1:1:1. So second one is the answer. If it was homozygous, it would have been a different ratio. Second one is the answer. So 21st, second one is the answer. So this is a test cross. So you should be knowing this. Another one, back cross. Back cross can be any parent. Test cross is always a recessive parent. Back cross can be dominant parent or recessive parent. So that is why we have this statement. All test crosses are back crosses, but all back crosses are not test cross. So remember about that. So 22nd, identify the amino acid which is coded by single codon. That is, they don't have degenerate codon. So this is a very good question here. Tryptophan. See, serine can be synthesized by three different codons, but tryptophan is coded by only a single codon. So that is why the right answer is tryptophan. So the amino acid which is coded by single codon is tryptophan. 22nd, first one. 23rd, when cytoskeletal structures are involved in amoeboid movement of macrophages, so by microfilaments, so there is the microfilaments are involved. Okay. Which cytoskeletal structures? The microfilaments, cytoskeletal structures are involved in the amoeboid movement of macrophages. Intercalated discs of cardiac muscles are, is a tight junction, zonular adherence, macula occludens, communication junctions. So the intercalated discs, what are they? Communication junctions. So the intercalated discs in cardiac muscles are communication junctions. 25th question. A small boy is admitted in a hospital and passes through diagnosis. The gastroenterologist observed that the boy had a problem with lactose indigestion. Okay. Malfunctioning of which parts glandular cell caused this problem in him? So which parts glandular cells? So milk is digested by renin pigment, renin, isn't it? So it is in the, usually in the stomach. So malfunctioning of which parts glandular cells caused this problem to this patient? So was lactose indigestion intolerance is there. So the 25th, the answer is, first one is small intestine. 25th, the answer is small intestine. See, lactose digestion takes place by intestinal juice secretion, lactase, isn't it? So lactose indigestion, if it's happening, so the small intestine might not be having this lactase enzyme. So the problem for that is small intestine. Okay, small intestine is the answer. 26, statement one. Mitosis helps in the maintaining genetic integrity. Statement two, meiosis helps in maintaining constant number of chromosomes in given species from generation to generation. See, both the statements are correct. Okay, both the statements are correct. So first one, statement one and statement two are correct, is the right choice. Blood has hemoglobin but not RBC in. So which of that, blood has hemoglobin but not RBC in, which type of blood? Okay, so the answer is earthworm. So earthworm is having a red blood color. Hemoglobin is present in the plasma, but not RBC is not present. So earthworm is an example of an animal which has blood, has hemoglobin, but not RBC in it. Identify the one which has all organisms used in biological control of pests. Okay, pests it is utilized for. Penicillium, aspergillus, baculovirus, ladybird. Okay. Nucleopolyhedrovirus, ladybird, trichoderma, and bacillus thuringiensis. Trichoderma, aspergillus, nucleopolyhedrovirus, and dragonfly. Ladybird, penicillin, aspergillus, and nucleopolyhedrovirus. So you have to identify the one which has all organisms used in biological control of pests. So the Answer is second one. So nucleopolyhedrovirus, ladybird, trichoderma, and bacillus thuringiensis are the organisms used in biological control of pests. So second one was the right answer. So the types of vascular bundle participating in normal secondary growth of dicot stem is conjoint, collateral, and open. So it is very clear. They says they have cambium. It is open type of vascular bundle. So 29th, fourth one is the right choice. Conjoint, collateral, and open. In a healthy person, the proximal convoluted of tibule of nephron cannot reabsorb. What can it not reabsorb? So in a healthy person, so is it glucose, sodium, water, or creatinine? So creatinine cannot be reabsorbed by a person whose PCT of nephron is affected. Okay, so creatinine cannot be absorbed. So they cannot be reabsorbed. So next, 31st. So all the doubts, please mark the question. I'll be discussing with you separately, okay, at the end of the session. Which of the following is correctly placed for its reason for extinction? Passenger pigeon overexploitation, chicklet fishes, their large size, Bali tiger invasion of alien species, Stella sea cow habitat loss. Which of the following is correctly placed for its reason for extinction? So the 31st answer is passenger pigeon because of over-exploitation. Passenger pigeon is the for over-exploitation. That is the right option. Which of the following organs filter the blood and it traps the blood-borne antigens? Okay, it filters the blood and traps the blood-borne antigens. Liver, kidney, spleen, malt. So which of them does that job? So is it liver, kidney, spleen, or malt? So the spleen, so is going to filter the blood and trap the blood-borne antigen. So spleen is the answer. 32nd, third one, spleen is the answer. So 33rd, so benefits of mycorrhiza are tolerance to drought and salinity, resistance to root-borne pathogens, overall increase in plant growth and development, absorption of phosphorus. So you have to identify the benefits of this mycorrhizae, not the harmful nature of it, benefits of it from this statement. Okay, so which are the beneficial features of this? All the four are beneficial features of the presence of mycorrhizae. So they provide tolerance to drought and salinity. They are also resistant to root-borne pathogens. Overall, it increases the plant growth and development. So fourth one, and absorption of phosphorus. So A, B, C, D, all the four are correct in terms of mycorrhizae. 34th question. Vertebrochondral ribs of the human being do not participate in the formation of rib cage, are not bicephalic ribs, do not directly articulate with sternum. So rib cage does not directly articulate with sternum. So remember, the third one is the right answer. So 34th, third one is the right answer. One minute, dear students. Okay, so we were discussing about the 35th question, isn't it? So find out the pairs which are correctly matched with respect to each deviation of petals. So we have to find out which pair is correctly matched. Calotropis, volvate, dolichos, twisted, China rose, vexillary, cassia, imbricate. So among this, you should identify which is the correct option. So among them, so 31st, only one, the A and D are the correct option. Calotropis, they exhibit valvate aestivation, where there is no overlapping at all. Cassia, it shows imbricate aestivation. So one petal is completely out, one petal is completely in, remaining three are in and out. So calotropis has valvate aestivation, cassia has imbricate aestivation. That is the correct answer. So 35th, first is a correct answer. So the enzyme utilized for the synthesis of RNA molecules by using copolymers and homopolymers during deciphering of genetic code is, so DNA dependent RNA polymerase or reverse transcriptase, you can call it as. So it is enzyme utilized for synthesis of RNA molecule, not reverse transcription, by using copolymers. So it is DNA dependent RNA polymerase. So 36th one is, first question is the second question is the right one. Enzyme utilized for the synthesis of RNA molecule by using copolymers and homopolymers are DNA independent RNA polymerase. Okay, so the second one is the answer for 36th. 37th, so you have to identify the correct sequence of stages in primary succession in water body. So it seems to be right. A, B, C, they have it right. Then D, E, F. So the correct sequence would be, first one would be A, B, then G, A, B, so these are the sequences that we have, okay, A, B, E, G, A, B, E, G, D, C, and F. A, B, E, G, D, C, and F. Okay. So that is the most appropriate answer. So 37th. So A, B, G. So sorry, it should be G first. G, E, D, C, F. Okay. First one is the right answer. So if you look into it, A, B, G is the next one. E, D, C, and F. So it should be the first one, A, B, G, E, D, C, F. So this is the correct option. Which one of the following is not involved in knee-jerk reflex? So the 38th question which we have, which one of the following is not involved in knee-jerk reflex? Is it muscle, spinal, brain, interneuron, motor neuron? So brain is not involved in this knee-jerk reflex. So 38th, second one is the answer. So 39th, identify the algal member with oogamy and accompanied complex post-fertilization charges. So you have to identify the algal membrane with oogamy and accompanied complex post-fertilization changes. The answer is polysiphonia. So second one is the answer. Which of the following functions is not likely to be disturbed if any injury occurs to hypothalamus? See, urge for eating would be affected, integrity of pituitary, thermoregulation, all this will get affected if an injury localizes to hypothalamus, but respiratory rhythm won't be affected. So fourth one is the answer. So 40th, fourth one is the answer. Then we have the 41st. So which variety of cauliflower is present to black rot and curl blight, black rot disease. So which variety of cauliflower is present? Is it Pusa Komal, Pusa Sadbahar, Pusa Shubhra is the right answer. The Pusa Shubhra variety of cauliflower is resistant to black curl, black rot and curl blight, black rot disease. So these are all fungal diseases which they are resistant to the Pusa Shubhra. So the 41st is Pusa Shubhra is the cauliflower variety which is resistant to that. The phytohormones that control xylem differentiation is, so which is the phytohormone which controls the xylem differentiation? Auxins are the answer. So next 43rd question. So you have this tabular column. Identify the correct combination from the following. Growth hormone, hyposecretion. It causes acromegaly. It has to be hypersecretion. Thyroxine, hypersecretion. Graves' disease. So second one is correct choice. Thyroxine, hypersecretion, Graves' disease, where the eyes are popped out. Yeah, you might have seen it in the PowerPoint presentation, isn't it? So second one is the right answer. If in the process of decomposition, which steps operate first? So fragmentation and catabolism, leaching and humification, mineralization and fragmentation. Fragmentation, leaching, and catabolism operate simultaneously. So 44th, the answer is fourth one. Fragmentation, leaching. You can remember that code word FLCHT. Okay. So fragmentation, leaching, catabolism, humus formation. So FRCLHT. Okay. Humification, and finally the last one, so mineralization you can come across. Which hormones from the ovary are dominating before A and after B ovulation during menstrual cycle? So which hormones from the ovary are dominating before ovulation and after ovulation during menstrual cycle? So very good question it is regarding this menstrual cycle, premenstrual cycle, postmenstrual cycle they are talking about. So the answer is it progressive progesterone estrogen, or is it second one, estrogen progesterone? So estrogen is the A answer, progesterone is the B answer. So this is the correct one. So 45th, second one is the right one. Nucleosome consists of DNA only, DNA plus histones, DNA plus RNA plus histones plus non-histones. So 46th, the right answer is second one, DNA plus histones only. Match the items given in column one with those in column two and select the correct option given below. See, biomagnification, nutrient enrichment is happening. Okay. Or biomagnification, the best is indiscriminate usage of DDT, accumulation of this DDT in the food chain. So A3 we can remember it as. So the 47th question, A3 is there. B, eutrophication, nutrient enrichment, B4. Then C, 2, UVB radiation causes snow blindness. Jhum cultivation is, after deforestation, there is jhum cultivation, D1. Okay. So A3, B4, C2, D1. So second option is the right answer. So there is a repetition of choice. Even fourth one has A3, B4, C1, D2. No, there is interchange here. C is 2 and D is 1. So second one is the right option. Okay. Fourth one, since C and D are wrong, so the entire question, the answer key itself is wrong. Second one is the right answer. 48th question. During glycolysis, which of the following steps shows reduction of coenzyme? So which of the following steps shows reduction of coenzyme? So the 48th question. So which is the step which shows reduction of coenzyme? Is it 1,3 biphosphoglyceric acid to 3-phosphoglyceric acid where there is reduction of coenzyme? No, that is not the right answer. Glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate to 1,3 bisphosphoglyceric acid. So this step shows reduction of coenzyme to phosphoglyceric acid. So third one, so 48, glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate to 1,3 bisulfate phosphoglyceric acid. So second one is the right answer. So 48, second one is the right answer. ZIFT is an assisted, ART we call it as assisted reproductive technique, which can provide a child to childless couple. In this technique, which of the following is or transferred into the fallopian tube? So zygote or embryo up to 8 blastomeres are transferred into the fallopian tube using the ZIFT, zygote intrafallopian tube transfer. So you can easily know the transfer is zygote or embryo up to 8 blastomeres. 50th, Melvin Kelvin was a professor of botany, chemistry, biochemistry, or was it plant physiology? So the Melvin Kelvin was a professor of chemistry. Okay. When the ovum is fertilized by the sperm without sex chromosome, can form a reproductively healthy individual in grasshopper, butterfly, fowl, human being. So when the ovum is fertilized by the sperm without sex chromosome, can form a reproductively healthy individual in which of them will it form? So the 51st, in grasshopper, so there is ovum is fertilized by the sperm without sex chromosome, so they can form a reproductively healthy individual in grasshopper. So 51 is first one. 52nd, natural cannabinoids, cannabis, are obtained mainly from the following of cannabis sativa. So is it dried latex, inflorescences, dried seeds, or is it root tips? What they use as cannabis. So which part of it is it? So the 52nd question, so it is inflorescence part, they are using it as the cannabinoids. So they are extracting it from inflorescences. Carriers are possible in both the sexes for thalassemia because it is a dominant disorder, or is it a recessive, autosomal recessive disorder, or an allosomal recessive disorder? See, carriers are possible in both sexes for thalassemia because they have an, so the 53rd, second one is the answer, an autosomal recessive disorder it is. So that is why carriers are possible in both the sexes for thalassemia. Most of the euglenites are found in, so the 54th question, so most of the euglenites are found in fresh stagnant water. Identify the following. Okay. So the 55th question, identify the following. First one is right. A is mucor, B is aspergillus, C is agaricus, the edible button mushrooms. So first one, A is mucor, second B is aspergillus, C is the agaricus or the button mushroom, edible mushroom. In the chronological order of human evolution, which one of the following is earliest? So 56th, it is going to be third one. Ramapithecus is the earliest as far as chronological order is concerned. So 57, gemmae are the specialized structures produced in liverworts. So gemmae are specialized structures produced in liverworts. These are green multicellular asexual buds which develops in gemma cups. So these are multicellular asexual buds which can develop in gemma cups. So 57th, second is the right answer. 58th, in which of the following plants Underground stems spread to new niches, and when older parts die, new plants are formed. Is it Pistia, Icornia, Agave, grasses and strawberry, hibiscus? So I think it would be more of 58th is third one. Yes, grasses and strawberry. So they spread to new niches, and when older plant dies, new plants are formed. So grasses and strawberry is the answer. Which of the following is caused by a protozoan? Influenza, it is virus, genital herbs, it is a virus, gonorrhea, bacteria, it is caused by trichomoniasis, so which causes black fever. Okay, so that is by a protozoan. So 59th, fourth one is the right answer. 60th, the correct match is marginal. So marginal, it doesn't come on the margin. It is parietal placentation. Axile placentation exactly at the center. C, parietal free central placentation, it should be. Fourth is free central, they have given it should be basal placentation. Marginal placentation. And here it would be peripheral placentation. So the correct matches, we have to give the correct match out of this choices that they have given. So the 60th is, first one is a correct choice. A is V. B is 2. C is So B is 2, C is 1, D is 3. So that is the answer for the 60th one. First one is the right answer. E is 4. Okay. So that is how you answer all the questions. 61st, which of the floral part is involved in false fruit formation in strawberry? Is it peduncle, thalamus, pedicel, petiole? So which one of them is involved in the formation of false fruit formation in strawberry? So the 61st answer is thalamus is involved in the formation of false fruit formation in strawberry. See, the shorter and longer arms of a submetacentric chromosome are referred as P arm and Q arm respectively, Q arm and P arm respectively, M arm and N arm, S arm and I arm. So what is the shorter and longer arms of a submetacentric chromosome referred to as? Okay. So the 62nd, it is referred to as P arm and Q arm respectively. 63rd, Rosie is a buffalo breed developed by close breeding. So it's a transgenic sheep meat production, cloned goat for extraction. So we are talking about cattle and they are talking about goats and fur extraction. So 63rd, so the answer is fourth one. Transgenic cow, it is a buffalo breed, it would be a transgenic cow, carries human protein alpha lactalbumin gene. So fourth one would be the right answer. It's a transgenic cow, carries human milk protein alpha lactalbumin gene they have. So 63rd, fourth is the right. 64th, which plant form of the following is the ancestor of ferns and conifers? Is it cycads, lycopods, Jostereophyllum or Xylophyton? Which of them is the ancestor for ferns, that is pteridophytes and gymnosperms? So the 64th question, the answer is fourth one. Xylophyton is the connecting link for ferns and conifers. So remember the Xylophyton. 65th, the kind of parasitism that does not involve feeding on the body of host is ectoparasitism, endoparasitism, hyperparasitism, or brood parasitism. So what is the that does not involve feeding on the body of fleshes of hostess? So which one of them is the answer? So the brood parasitism, 65th, the answer is third one, brood parasitism or coel on chrome. Identify the following structure. Is it lecithin, oleic acid, cholesterol, or palmitic acid? So 66th, the answer is cholesterol. This is the structure of cholesterol. all require in in vitro fertilization except test tube baby procedure, GIFT, ICSI, ZIFT. All require in vitro fertilization except in which test tube baby procedure? So is it in test tube baby procedure, GIFT, or is it interstitial cell stimulating, ICSI, okay, or is it ZIFT? In which of this all require in vitro fertilization except? So the 67, the answer is second one, GIFT, gamete intrafallopian transfer. See, this is a population growing in a habitat with limited resources shows initially lag phase, acceleration phase, asymptote phase, deceleration phase. So there is a population growing in an habitat with limited resources. They are going to show, so lag phase, initially they exhibit lag phase. Read the following and identify the correct ones. See the anabolic pathway. Anabolic pathway, so is endergonic, while catabolic pathway is exergonic. So that is correct. So first one is correct. All biomolecules have turnover, yes. Acetic acid can form alcohol, yes. So flow of metabolites through metabolic pathway has a definite rate and direction. It is called dynamic state of body constituents. That is also yes. All the four options are correct. So four options are right choice. Identify the false statement. In a girdled plant, root dies first. If bark is girdled from the main stem of a tree, the plant dies because ascent of sap is stopped. So this is the assertion. See, if xylem is removed from the main stem, leaves wilt. D, in flowering plants, food is transported in the form of sucrose. So let us understand this 70th question. So the right answer would be only B. B is the only right answer. If a bark is girdled from the main stem of a tree, the plant becomes dies because of ascent of sap is stopped. So B only is the answer for 70th one. See, inverted pyramid never seen in pyramid of energy. So 71st, third one is the right answer. 72nd, which of the following is not used in the hydroponic? Soil is not used. So 72nd is third. 73rd, during light reaction of photosynthesis, which of the following phenomena is observed in cyclic and non-cyclic photophosphorylation? So which is the phenomena that is observed in cyclic and non-cyclic photophosphorylation? There's ATP formation, NADPH2 formation, involvement of both photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. So these are the options that they have given. So one which is observed in both is ATP formation. So 73rd, the right answer is second one, ATP formation. The photopigments in the human eyes are composed of opsin X and retinal Y. Okay. So opsin is opsin protein and retinal aldehyde of vitamin A and retinal aldehyde of vitamin A. So that is what the fourth one is, the right answer for this. Regarding the Rubisco, which of the following statements are correct? It is an enzyme. It is the most abundant protein on the earth. It catalyzes the beginning steps of both photosynthesis, photorespiration, and Kelvin cycle. All of the above. So which of the following statements are correct? See, Rubisco is an enzyme, most abundant protein on the earth. So the 75th, the answer is fourth one. All of the above is an important step of the Rubisco enzyme, all the above. So next we have to identify the mismatched combination. So you have the 76th question. So that is cropland, least genetic diversity, ecosystem, self-sustainable unit. So they're all correct. Decomposition, purely anaerobic process. This is the wrong statement. Identify the mismatched combination. Third one is the mismatched competition. Decomposition is purely anaerobic processes. Wrong. It can also take up through aerobic process. So 76th, third one is the right answer. 77th. What is the right sequence of electric flow in complex 4? So again, this is the third one, copper A to cytochrome A, cytochrome A to cytochrome A3, and copper B. So 72nd, 77th, third one is the right option. Okay, that is in the proper sequence. During the production of recombinant DNA, the use of DNA ligase forms. Does it form ionic bonds, hydrogen bonds, phosphodiester bonds, or peptide bonds? So the use of DNA ligase, what does it form? So the 78th, it is going to form phosphodiester bond. That is the right answer. Okay. Already, so areola, yes, what is areola? Intercellular space in testes, ring of pigmented skin around nipple, interstitial fluid filled space in ovary. So the 79th one also have the answer, ring of pigmented skin around the nipple. So that we call it as areola. Okay. 80th, all of the following are included in in situ conservation except, is it National Zoological Park, Maplelung Sacred Glow, Kasiranga National Park, Wildlife Sanctuary. So which of them in situ conservation except? So 80th, the answer is first one. So National Zoological Park, Botanical Garden, they are all in situ conservation. So all of the following are included in in situ conservation except National Zoological Park, which is a ex-situ, okay, conservation. So answer is National Zoological Park. Okay. 81st, in flowering plants, the site for perception of light or dark duration is leaves. 81st, second one is the answer. So 82nd, which of the following event does not take place in acidic pH in humans? So we have to see which of the events are not taking place. So 82nd, second one. So fourth one, DNA, the nucleotide. So that is not taking place in acidic pH in humans. So 82nd, fourth one is the answer. Statement one, complexity of protein molecule increases from primary structure to quaternary structure. It is true. Hemoglobin molecule shows quaternary structure. Both statements one and two are correct. So 83rd, the right answer is first one. Both statements one and two are correct. In male cockroach, the genital pouch is bounded by, so you should remember the correct answer for this, 84th. So it is going to be the 9th and 10th terga dorsally and 9th sternum ventrally. You have this genital pouch is bounded by 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th tetsa dorsally and 9th sternum ventrally. Okay, next question that we have is, identify the incorrect combination based on its function. Air bladder in fish. So it helps in buoyancy, correct one. Parapodia in nereus, heat insulation. Radula in snail, rasping of food. Air sacs in bird, supplement respiration. So what is the incorrect statement here we have to identify? So 85th, parapodia in nereus, heat insulation is wrong. They are used for respiration, locomotion, everything. So parapodia in nereus is meant for heat insulation. 86, when a plasmolyzed cell is placed in water or hypotonic solution, what happens? Okay, so when they are placed there, so what is going to happen? The cell retains its normal size. That is one aspect of it. So 86th, so the turgor pressure also increases by entry of water. So when a plasmolyzed cell is placed in water or hypotonic solution, what happens? There is entry of water and turgidity develops. So the turgor pressure increases. So 86th, turgor pressure increases. 87th, secondary xylem exhibit. mesarch, endarch, exarch. So secondary xylem exhibit what type? Or no differentiation of protoxylem and metaxylem. So 87th, so no differentiation of protoxylem and metaxylem takes place in secondary xylem. Which set differs from homology? Hearts of fish and lizard, brains of frog and man, wings of insect and bird, so four limbs of whale and pigeon. So which set differs from homology? So the third one, wings of insect and bird, so they differ from homology. Their origin is not the same, but function is same. So wings of insect and bird. The following is not a genetic disorder: glomerulonephritis, Duchenne muscular dystrophy, Tay-Sachs disease, Jacobs syndrome. So which is the not a genetic disorder? So 89, the first one, glomerulonephritis is not a genetic disorder. Ninth one, reproduction is synonymous with growth, cell division in unicellular algae, planaria, bacteria, amoeba, hydra. So A, C, D should be the answer. So 90th, second one is the answer. A, C, D only is the answer. Okay, dear students, have you understood about all of these? Any doubts or clarification now you can ask me.